of course, a load of helicopters come right above my house just as I'm about to start filming. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing my top, I don't even know, this isn't even a top five or anything. This is just my current favorite makeup products. So I wanted to do a little sit down video today, kind of sit here and talk to you guys about what the makeup products that I'm loving at the moment. So I thought I would kind of pick my top few and just go through them and tell you why I love them. So I'm going to start off with things that aren't makeup. So I've got a couple of bits of skincare here. I know I said in my last video, was it my last video? One of my last videos, that I don't believe in skincare. But then I realized that I do believe in skincare. It's just I don't know when certain products are working. So say I'm using an eye cream, like I don't really see how the eye cream can make me have less bags under my eyes, but there are particular products that I do swear by, and like I don't think that if you are using if you're not cleansing or if you are cleansing, then your skin's gonna be the same, because I think washing your face and all of that is really important. So yeah, I realized that it actually really came across in the wrong way. So the first product I'm going to be showing you is this. It's the Ordinary Azelaic Acid Suspension 10%, and this is basically for kind of marks on your face, like if you have any spots or if you have any marks from spots recently. Like my skin, it has never been like too bad, but in the last few months I've had quite bad, like they're not even like proper spots, they're just like pimples on my forehead, and I don't even know how to explain it, but they have recently kind of disappeared a little bit more, and they did actually leave like red marks kind of like on the center bit of my forehead here. And I looked up about what to buy, and it said the Ordinary Azelaic Acid was really good for them because it kind of helps even out the skin tone and get rid of marks. Anyway, it was like £5.90 or something, and I've been using it for like the last month, and it's actually helped so much. Like I don't even always need concealer here anymore because it just got rid of all of the marks, which I'm really pleased with. It's so affordable for what it is as well, and it's at it's so affordable for what it is. Next skincare item, I mean, I don't even know if you class it as skincare, but I do. I did actually mention it in my brow laminating video, I think, and that is the Burt's Bees Coconut and Pear Lip Balm. No, not the best smell, I'm not gonna lie, but it really is so moisturizing. I've got it on now. It adds like a little bit of a shine, so it doesn't make your lips like sticky or anything. It is so moisturizing. Like, when I have like dry lips, it will literally help me in one day. So I'll put it on in the morning, and by the evening my lips are already feeling moisturized, and I think it's only like £3 as well, so it's super affordable again. I actually remembered to put rings on today, and I feel like I've forgotten what jewelry it is, apart from like the necklaces. If I put them on and I just don't take it off for like 2 weeks, but other than that, being in my house, like I'm not gonna wear my rings, because fun fact about me, my fingers swell up in my sleep, like that is just horrible. But if I sleep with my rings, I cannot get them off in the morning, and it hurts. It really hurts. So next up on the makeup products, my first one is going to be the Huda Beauty Tantor. This is just a cream bronzer slash contour. I'm not really sure what it's actually defined as. Oh, contour and bronzer, so either or. I've got mine in the shade light. If I was going to order this online, I would have probably got medium, because I feel like normally when you buy a light shaded product that's contour, it's like quite light for like more fair skin. I'm not really tanned or anything, but normally I would go for a medium shade. Oh my God, I'm literally waffling so bad. Anyway, I went for the shade. What the hell? No, it didn't. It creates such a nice natural contoured shade for me. So I have never really used cream bronzers, and then about a year ago I decided to use like a darker foundation and put it as bronzer. And then because I don't really wear foundation on a day-to-day basis, I put the bronzer over the top, like powder bronzer, and it literally made it so much smoother. It didn't go patchy throughout the day. It was pretty much a lifesaver for me. But it doesn't go patchy, it's really smooth, it applies and it blends out really nicely into your skin tone. There's quite a big range of different colours as well. Next up we have a highlighter. So this is the Tickle Highlighter by Benefit. I looked at this when it got released, and they also got released at the same time as one called Cookie, which is like more of a champagne one. This is kind of like a rose gold kind of shade, so it's the gold, but it's got the pink flexes in, if you can see there. And it is literally stunning. Like, I would have said that this is more for kind of a deeper skin tone, because the gold, like, I normally wear a champagne highlight, as you can see today, but I went and got this one, and I actually love it. Like, the only thing I would say is that it does leave a little bit of like a pink mark on my face when the light is not reflecting off it. So if I was wearing it now and you couldn't see my highlight popping, like there would be just a kind of a pink streak on my face, which isn't the end of the world, because if I'm going out at night or anything, like to the pub, I'll either have like bright lights shining on my face, or there won't be any light and it'll be kind of dark, so you won't be able to see it anyway. That is just a really nice highlighter, something a little bit different as well from my normal kind of champagne tones, something that I can pair, and I can also really like putting it on the inner corner of my eye. I brushed my hair into this ponytail, forgetting that it was actually meant to be curly, and now it's just gone into a huge frizz ball. Next product is the Benefit, I was about to call it Maybelline, it's just not though, is it? Next product is the Benefit Gimme Brow. This is such an OG product for me, like I've always used it since like I first started out with makeup, because I feel like brow gel is such a kind of simple and yet effective product, especially if you're younger and you obviously haven't started plucking or waxing your brows yet. It's kind of good to just kind of keep all of the hairs in place and tame them on your face. Ever since I got my eyebrows laminated, I haven't been filling them in as much, but I have wanted to use this because it's got colour. I would normally use the 24-hour brow setter, which would just kind of hold the brows in place, but this is really good for kind of adding a little bit of thickness as well, rather than just setting them in place, because I feel like if I put the 24-hour brow setter in and I haven't got my eyebrows tinted and then I carve underneath and do a big look, my eyebrows don't really match to the rest of the makeup. So that is why I'm loving this at the moment, and also it has little fibers in which actually adds to, again, to the thickness of the eyebrows. Next product is the Max oh my god, I cannot speak today. Next product is the MAC Fix Plus in the scent Rose. I'd never used one of these products before, one of these Fix Pluses, and I saw everyone using it and I was like, I have to get on this hype. So I decided to go for the Rose one, which is actually really unusual for me because I don't like the rose smell, but I did smell someone else's before and I really liked it. So I got this one and it's literally insane. It really keeps your makeup in place, kind of helps to keep like the glowiness to your makeup as well. It's also a primer as well, so you can use this, it's like a multi-purpose item, and that is what I absolutely love. It's something that I can, if I'm doing my makeup on the train or something, or I'm going away for the weekend, then I can use this for primer and for fixing spray, so it's kind of two in one. I don't have to carry a load of makeup around with me. So yeah, I would highly recommend that. It's actually really nice packaging as well. I'm gonna spray some now. Look at that. I mean, I know it's wet obviously, but look at the shine, like I just love it. I'm all for dewy skin. Speaking of dewy skin, my next favourite is the MAC Strobe Cream. I mean, look at this tiny thing. This is literally just a sample. I do need to buy a full size one, but I got this in, oh, I don't know what it was. I have no idea where I got this, but I decided to use it, put it under foundation, put it on even if I'm not wearing foundation, just like under the cream bronzer and everything like that. And it is honestly my new favourite. Like, I'm all for glowy skin, and this just kind of helps to add that perfect pop of colour under my makeup, rather than, like, obviously when you put a highlight over the top, like, it looks nice, but then you don't have any natural kind of glow underneath, whereas if you pop this all over your face before applying foundation, it kind of adds the glow underneath the makeup, rather than just on top, if you know what I mean, like, in just certain places. So yeah, I'm obsessed with this, and I need to order a new one actually. Next up, I have a product that I got in my Birchbox. If you don't know what that is, it's like a subscription service in the UK, so you pay like a certain amount per month and then you get a box of 5 products. Some of them are minis, some of them are full-size products. I think this is a full-size one, but it's the Forgive Me liquid eyeshadow. Let me show you. I'm just gonna swatch it for you. Like, what the hell, tell me that is not insane. It's like a pinky champagne kind of color, and it's honestly one of the nicest things I've ever seen in my life, like one of my new favorite makeup products. I've never really got on the wave of using liquid eyeshadows because I like using powder eyeshadows, and I feel like you're kind of more limited because you can't buy an eyeshadow palette of liquid eyeshadows. But when I got this one, I'm kind of converted. Like, what the hell, look at that, it's insane. And it blends out so nicely on the eyes, properly makes my eyes pop as well, which I find it quite hard to do. So while we're on the topic of eyeshadows, I used this in my last video, which is a makeup tutorial. I'm not sure if that's my last video, I'm not sure what order I'm gonna put these videos up in, but it's the Morphe Jeffree Star palette. It just looks like this inside. Honestly, the most insane range of colors, and the most beautiful colors as well. Like, it's such a random palette, it's not themed or anything, it doesn't have a certain theme of colors or anything like that, or it's not all mattes or all shimmers. It's just a really big mix of colors. I'm yet to use these two. I've swatched them both, but I need to find an eyeshadow look where I'm going to use them. My most used ones are these two shimmers here, actually. Oh, these three, actually, like, just my favorite colors in the whole palette. They're most natural, they look so pretty, they're all such pigmented eyeshadows. But I think because there's such a big range of colours, like, you have so much more choice and you can kind of mix it with other palettes as well. Morphe is one of the most affordable, most pigmented eyeshadow brands there is, and I just love the packaging as well. Like, look how pretty that is, especially with like the monochrome. detailing at the front. So last but not least, we're moving on to eyelashes. So I use these in my makeup tutorial that I put up, and these are Primark lashes. I don't have the box of them, but my good friend Maddie actually left these at my house and I've now stolen them. They're mine now, but this is what they look like. Let me show you. I found out since the last video that they are either the shade Miami or Dubai, because I loved looking at the pictures and I was like, I can't even tell which ones they are, but Miami or Dubai, because they kind of go out towards the edges, if you can see that there. They're just kind of really wispy, quite full lashes, and I'm in love with them because you can either wear them with less makeup and just kind of have them as long lashes, or they go really nicely with doing big eyeshadow looks. I'll always go through phases where I would have one pair of eyelashes and I wear it all the time, but these are my current favourites. So yeah, they are gonna get some good use out of them, and as soon as Primark reopens, I'll be buying a lot more of them. I'm just hoping they don't break before then, because then I'll be in a bit of a sticky situation. So that is it from me. If you liked watching this video and you like the kind of talkative sit down video of things that I'm loving at the moment, then smash the thumbs up button and I will see you next time. Bye!